Chrissy, Diana here, back again with another episode of my unreason rotation series. I think it's number 14. So I've been to a record fair last Sunday and it was really cool and I found a lot of stuff. But I'm just showing a handful here because my videos tend always to be a little bit long on the long side. Because especially now with the needle drops, it's kind of doubling length, I have the feeling. And so I think just half an hour is way too long, and so I try just to include fewer records and hopefully it will get not that long. Say hello to Frank, another coffee painting I made. And yeah, just let's hop right in. The first one is Pharaoh Sanders, Village of the Pharaohs, impulse release from 1973. Table looks like this. I have the feeling that this is quite an underrated gem. I know a lot of people don't like it because it has a great variety going on, but I think it's interesting because Pharaoh is showing some other nuances of his musical talents here. The first side consists of the three-part Village of the Pharaohs and a really short piece called Myth. And the second side has three other songs. The thing is that the tracks were recorded in different years, which may add up to the non-consistency of this record. But I absolutely like it. And the three parts of Village of the Pharaohs alone would make me want to buy this record because it's just amazing. It's like all the great Pharaoh stuff, you know, the really hypnotic, spiritual, trip out Pharaoh Sanders goodness. And he's joined here by Sidarius Brown, Joe Bonner, Calvin Hill, Jimmy Hopps, Lawrence Killian, Kenneth Nash, and Kylo Kylo. Other tracks on the B-side have Cecil McBee on the bass and Stanley Clark on bass, Arthur Rapp on flute, and the first side is so good. It starts with a really kind of even groovy, funky bass line and has some Middle Eastern Oriental vibes to it, which is absolutely beautiful. The second side is more conservative, I would say, and not as freaked out as you might know from Pharaoh Sanders, but I think it's really breezy and really nice to listen to, and so for me this was definitely a great find. Speaking of impulse, we recently got a book which I'm really excited about to read, and that's The House That Train Built, a book by Ashley Kahn about impulse, which was originally released in 2006, and I'm including a little flip through so you can see it. And yeah, it covers a lot of extensive information about the label and the albums that were released on it, and so I'm really, really excited to read this. Thank you. The next one is Big Black Lion Walk. Big Black is an American percussionist. This is an absolutely cool Afro jazz funk album, I would say, which was released in 1968 over the awesome Uni label. And this one is just amazing. The first track is a sidelong track called Lion Walk, the title track, and this is so groovy. Yeah, it just includes some needle drops so you can see it for yourself. The next one is also a record fair find. I saw this in a crate and I was like, whoa, I never saw that record before, aside from the internet, and it was on my want list for quite a long time. And that's the original press of Hatfield and the North, which was released in 1974 over Virgin, and it's this absolutely gorgeous laminated gatefold cover, and I so love the cover artwork here and the hilarious insight, and yeah, it's really beautiful, and I think I don't have to say that much about it because it's quite well known, and we see and on beautiful Virgin label. Yeah, it's fantastic Canterbury jazz rock prog, and I'm so happy to have this. The fun thing here is that I'm not determined to buy originals. If I get one, it's really nice, and if I get it for a reasonable price, it's even better, but it's not like I have to get the first press. If there's an official reissue of something I want out there and it sounds good and it's remastered or everything, then I'm really fine to buy this. But the thing is, as I mentioned before, this one had light highlight scratches, and I was like, oh, I don't know. This record plays absolutely smooth. There's not even surface noise. It's amazing because sometimes I have absolutely new records, even top-notch pressings, and they have surface noise or they're crackling and they skip, which is the worst part. And I have the experience with buying older records, they sometimes might look a little bit rougher, but they play absolutely fine, and so that would be one reason to get an original for me. But otherwise, if it's a good pressing, I'm totally fine with a repress, but I'm so happy to have this finally in the collection. And that's Between Contemplation, album which was released on Virgo in 1977 on the Virgo Spectrum label. Yeah, I've talked about Between before. It's an ambient crowd rock band from Germany, and I have their albums Einstieg, the first one, and The Waters Open, the second one, and this is the fourth one, I think, and it's great as well. It's really laid-back, oriental, ambient stuff, I would say. I like this a lot when I'm reading or just wanting to have really smooth background music, then this is perfect for this. Next one, another German record. It's Jonathan, a self-titled album from 1978 over the AAR record company. I never heard before. Jonathan is an instrumental synth duo, and Peter Grattatoni is playing drums here, and Helmut Grabs playing Minimo, Rhodes, Roland and Solina. This is quite interesting because the first track is so groovy. I'm putting needle drops in so you can see it for yourself, and it's just amazing. And yeah, it's kind of ambient synth stuff. Sometimes it's even bordering on the kind of 80s synth stuff I don't like, but overall it's a really enjoyable listen. Today is one that Fred was showing recently, and thanks for the reminder, Fred, because I thought this would come out in the middle of March, but then you showed it and I was looking up at my favorite online shop and I was seeing, oh, it's about to come back in a few days, and so I just grabbed it because now it's sold out and I'm pretty happy to have it. That's Shamik Farah First Impressions, which was originally released on Strata East in 1974. This is the 2017 Superfly Records release, and yeah, this is an absolute spiritual jazz gem. To brighten up your day, I thought I would end this video with one of my favorite pieces of music videos ever made by Eloy. And yeah, watch at the great equipment this guy had. Thanks for watching and bye.